You want me to stand up and go?
Well,
to make some vegan ramen, not just a instant noodle package, you know, but like real ramen. And since we are in just about almost America lockdown, like all the restaurants that I can go to are closed, so I have to make my own ramen at home. So we're gonna try. It's experimental. I've never made real ramen at home, so let's see what happens.
Let's turn on our pot
first, because it takes the longest to cook. So, first thing we're going to do is, I have 4 cups. A lot of this, you don't need measurements. It's just your choice of flavor, what you like. But, just to give some kind of measurement here. Alright, so 4 cups of veggie broth. And I have 2 tablespoons of sesame oil. Y'all can even see me doing this. 2 tablespoons of avocado oil. Need all that fat in there, you know, since it's vegan, no meat in there. So we need the fat that technically the meat would be given. I gotta figure out a way to clean this thing because it just keeps going. Alright. This is 3 tablespoons of soy sauce. Technically, it's like a tablespoon of soy sauce because I don't have like that much left. And 2 tablespoons of coconut aminos. Even though I don't like to cook with coconut, but I just happen to have it. So we're going to have to substitute it. And I ain't trying to go out to the store to like fight people in line right now. Alright, this is 1 tablespoon of coconut vinegar. It calls for like rice wine vinegar, things like that. I don't have that. So we're going to do coconut vinegar since I'm already cooking with the other coconut. This is definitely not going to be something I'm going to cook every day with all this coconut in. This is 1 teaspoon of key lime juice. We have 1 teaspoon of agave. Sorry, y'all can't see these things because they're in a blue thing and my camera's pretty far back there. Two heaping tablespoons of mushroom seasoning. Mushroom powder, seasoning, whichever one you have. This is 2 heaping tablespoons of chickpea miso, not the soy, but chickpea. Try to use as less soy and chickpea as possible. Keep the intake down on that. But sometimes, gotta use them in some recipes. Now this, we have 2 heaping teaspoons of onion powder, 1 teaspoon of dried sage. It's rubbed dried sage. This is 1/4 teaspoon of agar-agar. This is usually used as a gelatin, but I want to make this a thicker broth because that's what the gelatin does in meat. Like when they put the pork belly and things like that in there, it makes a little gelatin for it. That's why we're also adding both of the oils. It makes it pretty thick, but not too much because it'll make it a solid because it is like a gelatin. This is 1 teaspoon of black pepper. This is 1 teaspoon of dried red bell pepper. 1 teaspoon of sea salt and just a pinch of red pepper flakes because y'all know I'm scared of heat. So, but it's usually like sriracha or something like that, or the chili flakes in your ramen. All So now I'm going to stir this up. Get everything all mixed together. I'm going to have to just bring y'all closer, I think. Mix in that miso pretty good. Your seasonings, stir them all around. I don't know why every time I start the video, like all of a sudden I get dry mouth. That's because usually I don't like to be in front of cameras and none of that. I am not the spotlight person, really. All right, so now we have to add our vegetables, and I have a whole slew of them. This is baby bok choy. I did kind of sear them a little bit, so they can get a little more flavor, just a little more in depth, a little choy. Charred them a little bit. This is about 6 of them. This is a charred half onion. Just stick it right down off in there. This is about a half of a head of garlic, just smashed. There's probably about 4 little cloves, 5 in there. This is 3 green onions. This is 2 carrots. Not really a carrot fan, but I know it's always used in like ramen. I have, this is baby bella mushrooms. That's all I can find at the store right now, because of course everything is sold out. That's about 1.5 to 2 cups of them. They were just the sliced ones. Now these right here are Namiko mushrooms. They are dried. I don't know if y'all can see them. And this is about 1.5 cups of them. Then I have a thumb, well not a fat thumb, maybe 2 fingers of ginger. And just 1 nori sheet. I just folded it into 4s and broke it up. And we're gonna mix all this together. Now what you wanna do after this, ooh, look at all that. It looks like a nice soup already. I gotta show you guys, hold up. Now look at that. That's not even with any water yet. That's just the ingredients right there that I just put in. That already looks like a nice soup. I don't know. I might just eat this like this. No. Let me finish what I'm doing. All right. So now we have to add some water. You just want to fill this up to high as you can get with water and let it boil. So let's go back to doing that. Let me put this camera down. Okay. So now we just want to fill the top with water. Top it off. And I'm going to say that's pretty good. And we got to let this come to a rolling boil. After we do the rolling boil, you're going to put it on medium heat, I would say. And then you're going to let it go for about 1 hour. I'll come back when we get to a rolling boil. Okay, so don't know what happened to my camera. I am up. But something happened and it's not recording right now. So I have to show you guys what it looks like at a rolling boil. And then we'll wait the hour. I'll check my camera. I'll see what's going on. But I just want to show you guys that. So hold on. Let me flip the camera around on this tablet. Okay, as you guys can see, it's a rolling boil. This camera is up close.
And I'm going to now just turn the heat down a little bit, bring it to kind of a simmer, and we're going to cover it with the lid and just let it go for about an hour. I'm going to check on it in about 20 minutes or so, see how far it's reduced. If it's down too low, I add a little bit more broth to it, but I want it to be reduced a little bit because I want the flavors to concentrate. So just check on it. If it's too low, add some more water or broth to it. Give it about an hour to simmer and I'll be back. Let me try to fix my camera. Okay, it has been an hour. Our broth should be good and boiled and ready. Look at all that steam. Always get that off your top. That's seasonings right there, Biba. Seasonings. Alright, so my broth is looking very good. Smells very good. During the hour, I hope you tasted it, you know, corrected all your measurements for your seasonings. So now what I'm going to do is go strain this so I can just have the broth take all the vegetables out and seaweed. But while I strain this, I'm going to start my noodles. This is just some regular ramen noodles. Can you guys see that? Seven. I just picked this up at the Asian store. It's just flour and water. Flour, salt, and water. There's like really nothing else in there. Cook your ramen to package directions. Mine say about 2 minutes, so I'm just going to go ahead and let that boil off of camera, bring that back. We're going to saute some vegetables, and then we're going to put this thing together because I'm ready to eat. I'll be back. Okay, I'm back. I have strained the broth. As you can see, there's no more vegetables in there. I'm just going to put it on this side, put it on warm just to keep it heated up because you like your ramen to be warm. Don't want it to be cold. On this side, I have my pan already heating. We're just going to saute a few vegetables. Most of them are raw that I'm going to put in the ramen, but I like a few sauteed. So, some sesame seed oil. Just a little bit there. Now this is just a mix of soy sauce / coconut aminos because, like I said, I'm running low, so I try to split it half and half. And some minced garlic. But what we are going to saute today is going to be some portobello mushrooms, baby bellas, some carrots. Look at these little tiny king oyster mushrooms I found. So I just split them in half. I just brought those over here to show you guys what they look like. They're so cute. And I got a little onion right here, but I don't think so. That's just something when I was cutting up onion. So we're going to saute these. Happy don't really like for his mushrooms to be juicy like. So we're going to try to really sear them really good. Go ahead and start adding these in here. Don't knock nothing over. Get them all a little oil on there. Thank you. Now they have a pretty good sear. We're going to put a little bit of our concoction in there. Get a little flavor. Now this time I don't need to really put a little flavor there, do I? I'm not really a carrot person. You know, it's got a lot of seasoning, so let's go ahead and flavor dab it up. Flavor. They're tender enough, but still got a little crunch to them, so we're going to go ahead and take those out too. Now we're just going to add a bok choy. Give that a little flavor too. Make sure everybody get a little bit of that seasoning. Thank you. that is the end of our sauteed vegetables. So now, let's just clean this up, go get our noodles and our other vegetables, and we'll be back to put it all together. Okay, so everything is ready. Our noodles are ready. I put a little bit of the broth in there just to keep them from sticking. And we got some toppings here. I got some bean sprouts, purple onions, red and yellow, bell peppers, a little spinach, some green onions, my vegan eggs, some pickled ginger. There's some seaweed. This is roasted seaweed. And of course, you already saw the two types of mushrooms, the carrots and the bok choy. I also have some black sesame seeds, some hemp seeds, and regular sesame seeds. So let's get started with putting this together. So the way I see they do this is first they start by adding their noodles. And I like quite a few noodles, so we'll put that down off in there like that. Then some vegetables here. So let's start. I don't know where I want to start. Let's do a little broth first. Some mushrooms. A few carrots. Don't eat a whole bunch of them. That's why I didn't cook that many. Some bok choy. Now, do some purple onion. It's not gonna look pretty, huh? A few bean sprouts. Of course, some bell pepper. A little spinach on the side, a little more bell pepper, a little pickled ginger, I'll take the half an egg. Well, for a photo, let's just do a full egg. Let's do two of those. Now, a little bit of seaweed stuck down off in there. Little green onion over here. Can't see the bean sprouts now, huh? Can ya? Now, what are my seeds? I think I'm going to do a few black seeds. Black sesame seeds. For my own.
and some hemp seeds. I'll skip the regular ones, the regular sesame seeds. And there we are.
My vegan ramen bowl is all done.
All right, so let me go find Happy for a taste test of this, and I'll be right back. All right, so now our ramen is all done. You guys have saw the picture of it. It is time for a taste test. Here you go. Look who is going to do a taste test today. He's sleepy though, again. So, here we are, vegan ramen. Let's just try the noodles and the sauce first, myself. I really like that sauce. Actually, this is pretty good to me. Maybe even a little better than those restaurants.
Yeah, it's very tasty.
He usually doesn't like ramen because he doesn't like the instant packs. So, for him to say it's tasty, it's got to be good. Well, y'all, we're going to sit down and eat our food because it's hot, I'm hungry, and he's ready to go back to sleep. So, until next time, stay happy.
When I tell y'all this ramen is so good, like so good, like look at that. So good. Now the egg thing, it's actually working out. Like, can y'all see that? It tastes pretty good, like has an egg texture to it. The seasoning is amazing, like we're not gonna like taste it and say this is egg, but like the white part you definitely will. But it's awesome, y'all, especially in this ramen, like so good. The pickled ginger that's in there is awesome. This broth, let me tell you, it's very hearty, meaty, like as though I use some kind of pork fat or pork belly or something like that, some beef, something like that. So good, like so good. I don't know what to tell y'all. It is awesome. Like I done ate half my bowl already before I even thought to even say that to y'all. But anyway, make this ramen. It is good. You can put whatever vegetables you want to put in there, but the broth is awesome, like awesome. And that seaweed that's off in there, like picking it up with it, is just so good, y'all. Forget going to a restaurant and buying this. They should not have locked us down, because now I get to make stuff that maybe I usually would just run to a restaurant and buy. But I'm going to make this from now on. Also, another tip. The vegetables that were in the broth when I was making the broth, I did not throw those away. I am going to freeze it, and then when I want to make another ramen, that'll be my starter. I'll just throw it in a pot, add some more broth, water, seasonings, things like that, and let it simmer again. Keep going. So don't throw that away. That'd just be a waste of your vegetables. Freeze it. Use it again. That's it.